5 out of the total 11 PSU banks have been moved out of RBI's Prompt Corrective Action framework from January until now. Perhaps the urgency to take banks out of PCA has been prompted by recent weakness in the NBFC space in the aftermath of the IL&FS crisis. Let's do a three-point analysis to find out whether the decision has been taken by the RBI in haste and does it lead to more risks going forward. One, why are these banks out of PCA framework? Well, in January, RBI moved Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra and Oriental Bank of Commerce from the PCA framework, while Corporation Bank of India as well as Allahabad Bank are the latest ones to be taken out, along with another small private bank, Dhanlakshmi Bank. Now, these banks were recipients of large capital infusion by the government, which has actually led to an improvement in their capital adequacy ratios as well. In the past couple of years, most NBFCs have supported small and medium firms by lending to them, and the government wants to ensure that lending to these firms continues going forward as well. So the question is whether the PCA relaxation can actually fill the void created by the demise of weak NBFCs. And more importantly, should the weaker banks accelerate the credit growth pedal at this stage in time? And is it desirable for the economy in the long run as well? Two, did these banks deserve being taken out of the PCA? Well, these banks had plenty of bad loans, weak capital levels and low return on assets as well. While gross NPAs continue to remain elevated, most banks have actually resorted to significant provisioning and have succeeded in moderating their net NPAs. Now, in terms of profitability, thanks to the higher provision in the recent quarters, the reported picture continues to be dismal at this stage in time. In the first 9 months of FY19, except for Corporation Bank of India, whose profits were due to under-provisioning, the rest have reported losses. Now, Dhanlakshmi Bank and Oriental Bank of Commerce have reported minuscule profits in Q3 FY19. Three, what will be the impact on credit growth and could this move add to the risks? Well, RBI took these banks out of PCA to ensure they start lending, thereby partially filling the gap of weaker NBFCs. But the share of these six banks in the banking system's overall credit is only 10.3%. And unless they grow above the industry average, they are unlikely to move the needle quite meaningfully. Now, in recent times, PSU banks have lost their market share in deposits as well, which was rarely the case earlier. Now, PSU banks can, of course, loosen their purse strings with the fresh capital infusion, but given the disadvantage on incremental cost of funds, they will not be able to grab the best of assets and therefore lead to a rapid drawdown of the infused capital due to high risk weights of such assets. Now, ultimately, the question is, should the RBI add to the risks in the financial system in the name of fostering credit growth?